AI Quick Actions is a no-code solution to fine-tune, deploy, and evaluate large language models. In the Model Explorer, we can see a list of cached models provided by the service. The list includes text generation models, code synthesis models, as well as multimodal ones. For each model, we can see the model name, license, and attributes like the type of model, deployment and fine-tuning availability, and the supported compute shape. For model deployment and fine-tuning, we support GPUs such as NVIDIA A10, A100, and H100. We also support inferencing with ARM CPUs for models in GGUF format. In addition to the cached models, you can now import models directly from Hugging Face or object storage. Let's import a model from Hugging Face. When you select Register Verified Model, you get to select from a list of models hosted on Hugging Face, which were tested to determine which compute shapes could be used to deploy them, as well as which frameworks they will work with. An unverified model is a model the data science team has not tested. If you would like to register an unverified Hugging Face model, you can do that by using the model name, as specified on Hugging Face, in the model name search box. As you can see, the model has been found and some basic statistics are shown. Since this model is unverified, you will be asked to select a service-managed container you want to use with a model. We support models which are compatible with VLLM or TGI. If you selected a model in GGUF format, you will get a third option for a container that runs on Llama CPP. At the end of the registration process, we have the option to enable the model for fine-tuning. The last option for registering a model is from object storage, where you can again choose to deploy either a verified or an unverified model you have previously copied to object storage. AI Quick Actions allow you to fine-tune your models with your own dataset. From the Model Details page, which shows you important information about the model, click Fine-Tune. You can upload the dataset from your notebook environment storage or from object storage. You can update the validation percentage between test and train. The fine-tuned model will be saved to object storage. Next, we can select the desired fine-tuning instance shape. Let's deploy a model. For this deployment, we'll keep the default deployment name and deployment shape. Under Advanced Options, you'll be able to select the inferencing mode. The V1 completion endpoint is designed to generate responses based on a single input prompt. Alternatively, the V1 chat completion endpoint is designed for a multi-prompt chat-style interaction. Our model is now being deployed. Let's test the deployed model. Using the test section of the deployed model screen, we will send a prompt to our model and observe the response. We can also adjust the model parameters. AI Quick Actions can help us evaluate our models using industry standard benchmarks. We do this by creating an evaluation. First, we'll select one of our deployed models. We can select any combination of the evaluation metrics to be included in the evaluation report. In this case, we'll select all of them. As with fine-tuning, you can reference an evaluation dataset from the notebook environment storage or from object storage. Next, we'll create a new experiment for this evaluation. After that, we'll select a location in object storage to store the evaluation results. On the next page, you can update the evaluation parameters. In addition, you can select the instance shape, which will be used to run the evaluation. Once the evaluation is complete, we will be able to inspect the results. The evaluation page shows the general information and evaluation parameters, as well as the result summary for each metric selected when the evaluation was created. For full details, you can download the HTML report generated for the evaluation. The report will contain a tab per each of the metrics selected for evaluation. Thank you for watching the AI Quick Actions product tour video.